Okay, so your hangover has barely subsided, the mud has just about been scraped from your clothing, and I'm already here to talk about seven potential headliners for Download Festival in 2020. My name's beez, welcome to beez Says. Okay, so in this video, I'm going to be talking about seven potential Download Festival headliners. This isn't about my personal taste or whom I want to do it. This is just throwing ideas out there for who could potentially headline Download Festival next year. And that we're going to cover the likes of metal bands, classic rock bands, potentially returning bands, new headliners possibly. We'll cover all of that over the course of this next seven bands. Let me know in the comments section, obviously, who you think are potential headliners, if you think any of these are definitely not on the table. I always want to hear what you've got to say. So, first band to discuss are Rammstein, and that doesn't feel like it's pushing the boat out too much. When you look at 21st century heavier bands and the bigger bands of those, the sorts of bands that could headline Download Festival, Slipknot, System of a Down and Avenged Sevenfold are all massive bands, but none of them have stepped out on their own and headlined a massive outdoor show that is uniquely theirs in the way that Rammstein are doing in 2019. They sold out Milton Keynes Bowl really, really quickly. And while you have to speculate that a Knotfest could do the same sort of thing in the UK, they haven't actually done it. So Rammstein, always a safe bet. And the eagle-eyed amongst you will notice that this morning, as I'm recording this this video, Rammstein have put out a potential teaser for dates in 2020. And someone has slowed down the video around the 25, 26 second mark and noticed that there is a Belfast date around the time of Download Festival, and there are no British towns on that lineup of towns that are that Rammstein will be visiting in 2020. So you've got to think they are a potential headliner for Download 2020. The new record's out, it's really good, no one's going to complain about it. You can always rely upon Rammstein for a brilliant pyromaniac display of brilliance. So yeah, there you go, Rammstein, potential headliners for Download 2020. Next band are a classic rock band, and while I've given up all hope of Bon Jovi ever doing Download Festival because I just wish for it every year and it never seems to occur, Kiss are a band that have a long-running history with Castle Donington when it comes to Monsters of Rock and, of course, the rebranded Donington Park Download Festival. So they are currently on their end of the road run, which is allegedly the last chance that you're going to get to see Kiss. Now, Kiss have already done an arena tour in the UK, but what I find is when a band are playing their final UK date, you get a massive amount of bells and whistles around it. They shout it from the rooftops. You know, Motley Crue came back a couple of times on their farewell run. Slayer have just played their last UK date and it was like screamed from the rooftops. This is the last chance that you're going to get to see Slayer. Now, when Kiss did their UK arena shows, you didn't quite get that, did you? Which means, in my head, they could potentially headline Download Festival as a, this is the last time that you will ever get to see Kiss in the UK. So let me know what you think. Are Kiss a potential headliner in 2020? Next band. Now, this is a question that I didn't expect to ever ask. How much do you trust a Jonas Brother? Because in a recent interview, one of the Jonases, one of the Joni, I think it was Nick, could have been Joe. I don't know what the other one's name is, so I can't even put him in as part of this process of elimination. But one of the Jonas Brothers said that My Chemical Romance were rehearsing in a room next to them recently. Now, there's a couple of ways of looking at this. Frankie Aero has just put a record out, so it could have just been Frank rehearsing next to them. Two of the members of My Chemical Romance recently did some stuff with each other. So, not like that, stop giggling. So they could potentially have got that wrong, or My Chemical Romance are coming back. Now, this rumour rears its head every single year. My big thing on this is, why would one of the Jonas Brothers lie about this? They're Mormons, and Mormons don't lie, right? So why would they lie about it? And is it out of the realms of possibility that My Chemical Romance could come back? No, it isn't, is it? So, bearing all of that in mind, and with there being actual tangible evidence for this for the first time, again, depending on how much you trust a Joni, My Chemical Romance, possible download headliners in 2020. I don't think they would get the same wave of hate either. You know, download has changed a lot over the years. They have like a whole stage in terms of the Avalanche stage that is now catered towards lighter, more pop punk and that kind of Warped Tour-y type thing leanings. So I think they could potentially headline download in 2020. Not, you know, it's one of the further reaches on this list, but not out of the realms of possibility. Next up, now, co-headlines don't often happen at download, but when you look at the bands that are knocking on the door, you might not have faith in Alter Bridge as a lone headliner, and you might not have faith with Five Finger Death Punch as a lone headliner. But those bands always draw massive crowds at Download Festival. I wasn't at Download this year, but I was reliably informed that there was still loads of Five Finger Death Punch merch knocking around the festival. So, is it possible to put two risks together and have a co-headline event? I'm not sure there has ever been a co-headliner in Download's history. You know, the last time that happened was when Kiss and Ozzy Osbourne did it in 1996 at Monsters of Rock. But it's happened at Reading and Leeds in recent years. Queens of the Stone Age and Paramore co-headlined. And Alter Bridge and Five Finger Death Punch co-headline, both part of kind of the same thing while ticking different boxes. I think that is a potential for a Download headliner in 2020. Next up. Now, this is where it gets into slightly riskier territory, which is Blink-182. So Blink-182 have drawn huge crowds wherever they've gone. In fact, I saw them the same summer that AC/DC did Download, and that crowd was massive. I'm here to tell you that at Reading, the crowd was just as big for Blink-182. Could Blink headline Download? Now, they've never had an out-and-out pop-punk headliner at Download Festival. Even Green Day haven't done it, right? But Blink-182 have a new record coming. They have massive pedigree in the UK, and Mark Hoppus played Download Festival 2019 with his new band Simple Creatures. And I always like to read between the lines, and when Andy Copping, Download Festival headliner, it's a brilliant thought, isn't it? Download Festival organiser, Andy Copping, speaks in the press. He did mention Blink-182 in his wave of potential headliners for the future. So could 2020 be the year that pop punk headlines Download? Blink-182, possible headliners for Download 2020. Next up, do you know Metallica haven't done Download for 7 years now? So making it a potential 8th year into 2020. Now, you've got to think that the Hardwired to Self-Destruct tour cycle has got to be winding up now. They have played everywhere there is to play twice on this record. And they've got Australia dates with Slipknot coming up. And then I would imagine it's time to either start thinking about a new record, or Lars has been getting tongues wagging recently, talking about a potential new Garage Inc. collection. He said that in an interview with Kerrang. He said a watch this space when he was asked what bands would they cover if they were to do a new Garage Inc. So that has set people kind of chatting about that. Metallica are no strangers to an escape from the studio run of dates that usually happen in Europe. So, with all of that combined, and you like to think that they are the most reliable band when it comes to selling tickets at Download Festival. They are probably the biggest band that you can book for that festival. And with it being 8 years in 2020 since they last did Download, it's got to be a possibility for 2020. And the final band that I want to talk about comes with a whole bunch of pros and cons, and that is Bring Me the Horizon. So Bring Me the Horizon have been a band that people have championed as potential download headliners for a long time now, and they just did All Points East. Now, they were selling tickets for £2.50, which suggests that sales weren't what they'd hoped for or anticipated. That's the negative side of things. Also, Download Festival in recent years have really voted with their feet when it comes to things that aren't traditionally download, right? So when Biffy Clyro headlined and was up against Rob Zombie headlining on the second stage, it felt like everyone voted with their feet and went to go and watch Rob Zombie. I watched the start of Biffy Clyro. Biffy Clyro are fucking ace. They played really well, but there's no escaping the fact that everyone kind of went over to check out what Rob Zombie was doing. Now, with Bring Me the Horizon stepping into more experimental territory, and definitely away from the kind of thing that is popular at Castle Donington, that throws a potential spanner into the works. The other side of things is they are massive with the youth. They are a band that cannot even fart without everyone having an opinion on it. And when they released their Ammo record earlier on this year, it felt like everybody had something to say about it. So, could they headline Download in 2020? I think the All Points East thing will have done more harm than good. But can you name a contemporary band? I've mentioned Alterbridge, I've mentioned Five Finger Death Punch. Is there anyone more suited than Bring Me the Horizon? That's the question that I want to ask you. So those are my seven potential headliners for Download Festival 2020. Rammstein, Kiss, a returning My Chemical Romance, an Alterbridge Five Finger Death Punch co-headline, Blink-182, Metallica, and Bring Me the Horizon. Let me know what you think in the comments section below. Do make sure you subscribe, like the channel, ring the little bell so that you get notifications every time I drop a video, and I'll see you for more chat on this channel. I'm Beez, and this is Beez Says. See you next time.